Do you want to make instant $27 commissions over and over again? If so, check out the automated Cash App system. Link below.
Yo, UFC fighter Mike Perry gets caught on tape knocking some old ass dude out at a restaurant. Just seeing the video, right? Now take a look for yourself.
Let's go. I'll stay here. What do you want?
Go, Mike. Here's your phone.
I'll just wait here, bro. Don't worry about it. No. Y'all want to call? Y'all calling the cops? I'll stay because if I leave and y'all call, no. I have a side. I don't have to go anywhere.
Catch her again, mother.
Are you bringing the cops? Because if I leave, then I'm... Did you touch me? Oh, you didn't touch me? He touched me. So he touched me. He touched me. You can lie to him if you want to.
You hit him,
bro.
You hit him.
But y'all gonna tell the police that I fucking
am the police.
I'm not. I'll knock your ass out too.
You do it, my little
you fat piece of shit.
Hey, no.
You want to touch him too?
Back up!
Back the fuck up!
Call the police!
Please, stop!
Call the police! I ain't do s***! No!
Y'all back up! I'll be damned. This is why, you know, MMA fighters get a bad reputation because they get a reputation of motherfuckers like if they lose they cool, right? If they lose they cool, they can't control themselves. They be knocking motherfuckers out, or they quick to start some shit, or they quick to throw hands, right? That's what a lot of people, you know, that's their problem with a lot of the MMA fighters, right? Because technically, you know, with their profession, I don't know if MMA got to register their hands as deadly weapons or not, like boxers do. I don't know, but like Mike Perry, I swear, I just was telling my girl a couple weeks ago because he was fighting. And his whole attitude, his whole style, you know, sometimes you just get a vibe from people. And you could be wrong. Like, you see a person, you know, on a video or on TV, and you just kind of feel like you think you would know what they'd be like in real life, right? Right? You could be watching this video and be like, yo, this motherfucker seem cool as shit. You might meet me and be like, ah, he whack. Or you might meet me and be like, yo, he cool as shit. Most likely, he'll probably be cool as shit. But anyway, so Mike Perry always come off to me. He comes off to me like the dude that if you out and like you accidentally look in his direction, he comes off like the dude that'll be like, what the fuck you looking at? What the fuck you looking at? You know, he got that little wigger vibe to him. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what you got? Is there a problem here? The fuck you looking at? Like, that's how he always, every time. On interviews, that's how I come across. Like, he's the dude that he quick to show you that he can fight. He's quick to show you he can fuck you up. I could be wrong, but this video kind of proves my point a little bit. Now, I don't know the whole story. A lot of people, they only show like the part apparently where Mike Perry was asked to leave this bar, and I guess he punched one of the workers in the eye or some shit. And then I think Mike Perry was with his girlfriend, maybe his girlfriend's friend. So they were all walking out. And this is where the video you see, you know, and everybody basically trying to get him to leave. And you could just tell he got a fucking badass temper. You could just tell. You could just see it, right? And then the old dude that comes up to the left, right? It's kind of silly. But I'm assuming people do know who Mike Perry is at this point. I'm assuming motherfuckers was whispering at some point, like, yo, that's Mike Perry. Yo, that's Mike Perry. You know that's Mike Perry. You know he in the UFC. You know he a little crazy. Oh, Mike Perry. Oh, shit, right? I'm assuming everybody know who he is, right? So, he walking out. I think it's his girlfriend's friend trying to, like, yell at him. Like, Mike, get the fuck. Get the fuck out of here. Right? So, then the old dude said something to Mike Perry. He was like, yeah, and my parents like, what y'all gonna call the cops? What y'all gonna call the cops then? What? Cause y'all, why y'all gonna call the cops then? And the white dude was like, well, hell, it was all white people there. bitch. But anyway, so the old dude, that's what I meant to say. The old dude was like, yeah, you just talking about calling the cops. Yeah, we'll call the cops. Mike Perry looks at him. You can just see he just switches. He just look at him. He goes, I'll knock your old ass out too. Now, Mike Perry, you wrong. All right, you wrong for that shit. But, when the old dude steps towards Mike Perry, was like, do it, motherfucker. Now, I don't know if the dude, I don't know. Maybe he just had that old school, like, I don't give a fuck about the UFC MMA fight. I can scratch, you know. Or he didn't know who Mike Perry was, or he forgot, or maybe he just didn't care. But the fact that he walked up on him, I was like, when I'm watching the video, I'm like, oh boy, aye, right? Like, and Mike Perry, sure enough, you see, knocked him all the way out. I'm surprised he ain't pull a Debo. Well, what's that from Friday when Chris Tucker came up? I'm surprised Mike Perry didn't stand over that old man and say, you got knocked the fuck out, old timer. I'm surprised he ain't do that shit. Because, I mean, and then, right after he knocked the dude out, Mike Perry shows no remorse. You know what I'm saying? He keep it going and shit. Like, he like, I'm going out with a bang. So he just keep talking shit. Nah, fuck that nigga. Fuck that nigga. So, really quick to address that. On the Yahoo story I seen where he was, you know, the media was like, oh, he was using racial slurs. Yeah, he was. But let's be real. He was using it in the context of, like, I'm a wigger. I'm cool with that. He wasn't, like, adding an ER to it. No, he wasn't doing all that to the word. Although, it can rub people the wrong way. It do come off strange when I hear white people say nigga, but I don't care. But I think, you know, the media kind of ran with that whole racial slur stuff. It wasn't like that. Mike Perry, I think he black somewhere in his head anyway. So, I ain't worried about that. But he kept it going. But the thing that annoyed me was, if you look at the video again, you see another dude when Mike Perry sits down. Some dude put his fist out like, yo, we cool. And that's when Mike Perry looked up and was like, nah, fuck you, nigga. Fuck you. And the dude was like, he took his fist. He gave him a fist pound. Then he just took it back real slow. Like, oh, okay, I see we ain't cool. But, hey. Yeah, I proved my point. Like, Mike Perry, like, I always said, like, he seems like that dude. He seemed like that dude. And Mike Perry, his defense is, I guess in the video, he was saying, yo, the dude touched me. And the dude was like, no, I didn't touch you. And he was like, you didn't touch me. You didn't. I'm like, God, if you act like this in public, ooh, shit. What do you act like behind closed doors?
I let the chain hang, yeah, I'm tatted up, and I love to cuss, I just don't give up. See, I'm just doing me, and you should do you. Yeah, I hear you talking, that's just your point of view. And see, I just don't care, I be like, yeah, I done heard it all, damn, there's haters everywhere, and they keep me motivated.